All right, Eric, so again, I just watched your video where you said, okay, I should not be selling PPE. So what should I be doing? Great question. That's what I want to talk about. Feel like a teacher today. All right, so should you sell PPE? We established no. So what can What can you do? Man, there is a lot of stuff going on out here. And there's a lot of stuff that's going to be going on for 6 months, 8 months, 10 months, 12 months, 15 months from now as well. So again, there's a lot of stuff that people could do that are very simple. Look, about this? Janitorial. Everyone, right now, okay, if the unemployment is at 30%, if the unemployment is at 30% right now, okay, that means that any and everybody is sitting at home. 30%, I think our American population at one is close to 300 million people times 30%. That's 90 million people without a job. And again, that, I'm sure that's not factually accurate because they're going to say, well, you take out the older population that can't work and the younger population that can't work. And so this number really becomes whatever it is, 200 million, case may be. So let's say factually accurate, okay, we take out the people that can't work on the top and the bottom end. All right, we got 60. That's 60 million people that's sitting home that need a job. You could, okay, learn how to do janitorial business. You could be sanitizing facilities. You could be helping wash facilities. Every single building in America, every single building, doesn't matter what it is, your local gas stations, your food marts, your Walmarts, your stores are going to need to be sterilized and sanitized and clean moving forward. And I predict that this market, right, whatever number it's at now, let's say X, it's going to go up X 500%. So whatever the market is for janitorial services, I believe that market is going to go up 500%. So again, with all these people sitting home, the unemployment at 30%, the need for janitorial going up 500%, to me, that is a realistic business model for the average person with very little education to get into. Because why? I can tell you, we talked about it before, but the VA hospital, right? They are now doing 24 hours a day, 7 days a week cleaning. So how many more people are any you're gonna need to be able to ratchet up to service this need of 24-hour day, 7 day cleaning, right? So we're gonna need to be pulled from some of these people that are sitting at home and get them out here, get them the right PPE first, get them the right gear, the PPE, and everything they need to protect themselves and to stay safe out of harm's way. But we're gonna need some of these people to get up out of their houses who wanna work. Again, there's people out here that are really want to work for the fun for their simple fact of keeping their sanity and their sanctity. So again, we've got a lot of these people out here that are sitting home. We've got this opportunity over here. And so there's this huge need of gap to fulfill for doing janitorial services. So that is something that, again, I would say, look, it's a very low risk business. You're cleaning, you're sanitizing areas. There are people out here that can train you and teach you how to properly do it. And what I'm finding is that a lot of the bigger companies are not wanting to get in that marketplace because they don't have the ability to train people. But we have companies here that are in our group, are in our network that are doing these activities that we could effectively, if we had enough demand, they could put together training programs to start training people how to effectively clean services and do these things so they can be effective. So this is what I'm talking about. So there are some low-tech businesses that people can get into right now to start helping fight this challenge and not have to jump at the shiny object, okay? I don't want people out here to go out and get hurt. Now, that's just one area. If we start talking about technology, there's a whole host of opportunities for providing technological services for people to do this. But right now, I just want to touch on that. What are the things that you could be doing in the event that you can't really get into the PPE marketplace or the PPE business? This is a major area where I see increased demand, increased needs that is low tech.